Well, good afternoon, gentlemen. Thank you for having me on the show today. I think I'll start by just giving a little bit of history in that this whole concept of alert and warning goes back to 1951 with the establishment of the control of electromagnetic radiation program under the Truman administration.
Wow.
And has evolved over the last 65 years into what we have today with the integrated public alert and warning system. And so I don't know if you've heard, but on Monday, the president signed into law the Integrated Public Alert and Warning System Modernization Act, which, amongst other things, requires FEMA to modernize and implement IPAWS to ensure that federal, state, tribal, and local governments can alert the public in areas endangered by natural disasters, acts of terrorism, and other threats to public safety. And so that's really exciting for us within FEMA,
really,
and certainly for the citizens across this country that this type of attention is being given
to
alert and warning.
Absolutely.
But one of the major things that we've done over the last 6 years since I've been at FEMA is to adopt the Common Alerting Protocol, which is an extensible markup language standard that was originally adopted by the Organization for the Advancement of Structured Information Systems. With that single move, we built out capability in the form of the IPAWS Open Platform for Emergency Networks, and over the last 4 years have connected 49 states to this system, one-fifth of the nation's counties. We have two territories as well as tribal governments connected into this, as well as 26,000 broadcasters, 61 cellular companies, 65 internet content providers. And I really take pride in the fact that organizations like the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children are using the system to issue amber alerts and have attributed the recovery of 28 children to wireless emergency alerts or the receipt of this information over mobile devices. And, of course, the National Weather Service is one of our largest users in issuing severe weather warnings to citizens across the country related to floods and tornadoes and things of that nature.
That's cool.
So a lot of progress has been made over the last 65 years.
Yeah, see, that's good.